Hello everyone, a very good morning to all of you children. I hope you all are fine and safe at your home, right? So this video is for standard 2 and for day 3. That means we are going to do revision work of English as well as grammar also. Okay, so we are going to revise some questions from the chapter which we have already studied in our previous class. So in our previous video also. Okay, so we are going to do. So let's see what is written here. Choose the correct answer. That means some questions are there and we have to choose only one option, one correct option among four options. Okay, so let's start. Here is question number one. Grand plus father will make dash. That means we have to add two words. That one word is grand and the next word is father. We have to join these two words. That means grand plus father will make dash. Number A is grand. Number B is father. Number C is grandfather. Number D is all of these. Okay. So, grand. Number A. This option is not correct. Why? Because only grand is mentioned here, right? Only grand is written here. And we have to add two words. Grand and father both. Okay. So, this option is not correct. Option number B. That is father. This option is also not correct. Why? Because only father is mentioned here. Grand is not written. That's why this option is also incorrect. Number C, grandfather. Yes, whenever we add grand and father both, whenever we join these two words, grandfather will be the new word. So here we have to write grandfather. That means grand plus father will make grandfather. So you here you have to write grandfather. Okay, children, grandfather. F-A-T-H-E-R, father. And you have to write it down also and you have to correct the option also. Tick the option also, okay? So, this will be your correct option, that is grandfather. Moving towards our next question, but before that, I would like to show you the picture of grandfather. Here you can see, here the picture of grandfather is here and grandfather is one of the most important person in our life. Why? Because he is the one who is going to tell us the bedtime stories, right? At night, he used to tell us different types of stories. Grandfather, grandmother, these both of them are very important person in our life. Okay, children. And he is the one who is going to protect us from our father and mother anger. So, he is the one. So, grandfather is the most important person in our life. So, moving towards our next question. That is question number 2. The possessives for he is. Here, we have to write the possessive for he is dash. Option number A is him. Number B is her. Number C is his. Number D is there. Okay. So, here we have to write correct possessive. But before that, I would like to explain you, I would like to revise what is the meaning of possessive. Possessives are the words that tell us about ownership or possession of something. Okay, about ownership or possession of something. For example, this pen is mine. Okay, this pen is mine. This pen belongs to me. That means here possession is shown that this pen belongs to whom? Belongs to me, right? So here the possessive for he is dash. Him? No. Him is not the correct option. Her. No. Her is used for female. That means her is used for a she pronoun. Okay. He is. Yes. He is the his is the correct option. So you will write his. So the possessive for he is his. That means the correct answer is his. Okay, children. So you will write his. Moving towards our next question. That is question number 3. Who was the author of the story Owl and the Moon? Here we have to choose a correct author. An author that is of the story Owl and the Moon. So here Arnold Lobel is also mentioned. Option number A is Arnold Lobel. B is James S. Tippett. C is Rabindranath Tagore. And D is none of these. So, I am going to tell you something more about all the person mentioned here, whose names are mentioned here. So, Arnold Lobel. Arnold Lobel was born in California. That means he was born in California on 22nd May 1933, and he was an American author of children's book. That means he used to write different books for children. Okay, so option number B is James S. Tippett. Option number B is James S. Tippett. James S. Tippett was a writer as well as an educator also. Okay, and was born in 1885. He was also a respected teacher as well as principal, a coordinator also. So, he is not the author of the story Owl and the Moon. Next is option number C, that is Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore, he was a Bengali poet, writer as well as and composer also. And he was born on 7th May 1861 in Calcutta. So, Rabindranath Tagore belongs to our country. Okay, so here option number D is none of these. So, children, who was the author of the story Owl and the Moon? So the correct answer will be Arnold Lobel. Arnold Lobel. I'll show you the picture of Arnold Lobel also. Here you can see he is Arnold Lobel. Right, children? And he was born in California on 22nd May 1933. And he was an American author of children's books. Okay. So he was the one who was the author of the story Owl and the Moon. Okay, children. So here is question number 4. We should never be rude to each other. We should treat each other dash. Some options are there. Number A, angrily. Number B, respectfully. Number C, badly. Number D, all of these. So children, here we have to choose only one correct answer, right? So all of these will not be our answer. So this is wrong. So we have to choose one correct option among these three. So, angrily. So children, tell me, if we behave angrily with anyone, then they will not want to talk to us, right? Because we behave with him very badly, angrily and badly. We should not behave with anyone angrily and badly also. So A and C will be not our answer. So rest respectfully. That is option number B. Yes, we must treat each other. We should treat each other respectfully. We should never be rude to each other. So here you will write respectfully. 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 Okay. Respectfully. We should never be rude to each other. That means we should never treat anyone very badly or angrily. Or we should not be rude to anyone. And we should treat each other respectfully. So this will be your correct answer. Okay, respectfully, that is option number B. So you have to tick also and you have to write down the answer also. Okay. So here is question number 5. Okay, so here it is written, who was the author of the story Please Leave a Message? So children, do you remember that Please Leave a Message was a story about a boy that the name of the boy was Dudi, and how smartly what he did, he remember all the message and he drew the messages and very correctly conveyed both the message to his parents, right? So the story was about Dudi. Okay, so here option number A is James S. Tippett, number B is Arnold Lobel, number C is William Shakespeare, number D is Neera Herron. Just now I have told you about James S. Tippett and Arnold Lobel. So James S. Tippett was a writer and an educator also. He was a respected teacher as well as a principal also. A coordinator also. Okay. Arnold Lobel. Arnold Lobel was the writer of the book, of the story, that is The Owl and the Moon. Okay. So William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare was an English poet, okay, and an actor also. He was known as the greatest writer in English language and world's greatest dramatist also. So he was not the one who has written the story, that is the story Please Leave a Message. Okay, next is Neera Harrell. So children, Neera Harrell has written many children's books and has won numerous prizes also. And she was the one who encourages children to read. And you can see here, one connection is there. That is, in the story, Please Leave a Message, it was shown that how Dudi used his brain, right? How he used his smartness and how he conveyed both the message very correctly to his parents. And Neera Harrell also encourages children to read. That means through her story. So children, yes, Neera Harrell is the correct answer. So you will check Neera Harrell. Okay, Neera Harrell is the correct answer, children. Okay. Now I'll show you the picture of Neera Harrell also. Let's see. Yes, she is Neera Harrell. And she has written many children's books also. So here is question number 6. Dash is a place where people keep their money. That means money is a very valuable thing, right, children? We cannot keep so much money in our home, right? In our house, we are not able to keep that much money. So here are some options where we used to keep our money. So we have to choose only one option. Number A is bank. Number B is briefcase. Number C is envelope. Number D is none of these. So, children, we know that people used to keep their money, their valuable things, in bank. So, your correct option will be bank. Yes. B-A-N-K. Bank is a place where people keep their money. Okay. So, in this way, you have to choose your correct option. Moving, you can see here that this is the picture of a bank. Okay. So, question number 7. How many messages did Dudi have to give? So, here we have to choose a correct option. How many messages did Dudi have to give? 2. Option number A is 2. Number B is 3. Number C is 5. Number D is none of this. So we all know that Dudi have to give 2 messages to his parents. One was about the appointment of Miss Gina with a dentist, and second was Mr. Thomas Wolfe was visiting his father that night. Right? These were the 2 messages. So your correct answer will be option number A. How many messages did Dudi have to give? 2 messages. Okay, children. In this way, you have to choose your correct option. Question number 8. Dash is a word that tells us where a person, a place, an animal or a thing is. Option number A, preposition. Option number B, pronoun. Option number C, noun. Option number D, all of these. So here, all of this will not be our correct answer because we have to choose only one. So, we are not able to choose all the 3 options here. Okay, we have to choose only one. So, among 3, now we have to choose only one correct option. Preposition, pronoun and noun. So, children, firstly come to option number B, that is pronoun. Pronoun is used in the place of a noun. Right, pronoun is used in the place of a noun. Nouns, all the naming words are known as nouns, right? So, here, dash is a word that tells us where a person, a place, an animal or a thing is. That means it tells us about the position of nouns. Okay. So, preposition is the correct option because preposition, the other name of preposition is position words, right? So, preposition is a word that tells us where a person, a place, an animal or a thing is. So, here you have to write preposition. Okay, children. Preposition, P-O-S-I-T-I-O-N, preposition. Okay, children, Preposition is a word that tells us where a place, a person, an animal, or a thing is. Okay? This way you have to write your answer. Okay, children? So next question is question number 9. A person who keeps the law. Farmer. Option number A is farmer. Number B is teacher. Number C is writer. Number D is policeman. Now I'm going to deal with all the options separately. Number A. Farmer used to grow crops. That farmer grow crops for us that we eat. Right? So farmers are the food giver. Teacher. Teacher is the one who teaches students. That means teacher gives knowledge to the students. Writer. What is the work of a writer? Writer used to write. That means with the help of his pen, he used to write the knowledge of particular thing, or you can say story, novel, all the things in on a plain white sheet. So this is the work of a writer, that writers write books, right? Number D, policeman. Yes, the correct answer is policeman, because he is the one who keeps the law. That means who see that everyone is following that law correctly. No one is breaking the law. He catches thieves also, right? So this is the correct option, that is option number D, policeman. Policeman keeps the law. Okay, children, in this way you have to write your answer. You can see in this picture also, policeman is there, and what he is doing, he is keeping the law, that he is telling everyone to follow the law correctly, right? That is question number 10. How did owl shout goodbye? So this line is from the story, that is owl and the moon, right? And here we have to choose a correct option. Number A is loudly. Number B is angrily. Number C is happily. Number D is brightly. Now I am going to discuss about all the options one by one. Loudly. So yes, this will be the correct option. Yes, why? Because owl thought that moon was not able to hear the voice of owl. That's why he shouted very loudly that goodbye moon, angrily. No, because owl and the moon were good friends, and we don't shout on any friend, right? We don't show our anger on any friend. Happily. No, owl was not happy at all, because he was saying goodbye to his friend, which is very little bit sad every time. So, telling goodbye to everyone, saying goodbye to everyone, anyone, is little bit sad. So, owl was not happy. Brightly. We cannot say anything brightly. Okay. So, the correct answer will be, loudly. How did owl shout goodbye? Owl shouted loudly. So this will be the correct answer. Number A, that is loudly. Okay. Here you can see, this is the picture of the owl and his friend, that is the moon. So children, thank you for paying attention here. Thank you for watching this video. Okay. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye. Thank you, everyone. Be safe.